right then because I'd come back to Atlanta after being gone for 6 years. And so the next time I saw him, we went to a meeting that was a once a year annual meeting for the Mankind Project. And he was sitting right beside me, and they called to ask who might be interested in leading as the steward for the Southeast. And I was about to raise my hand, and Rusty stood up and said, "Me, me, vote for me. I want to run this place." And I thought, maybe I should just sit down for a little while here and enjoy the fact that he really wants to do this. The thing that I've learned in the Mankind Project is that it gives us an opportunity to let each man shine for all that he is. So, since that time, Rusty has started this men's group. We used to call him I Group, and if I say I Group, it's the same thing. And he's brought 13 men to be initiated in the Mankind Project. He served for 2.5 years as the steward. I served as the administrator along with him. God, I couldn't ask for anybody better. We worked as brothers. I'd like you to read what's on this because we gave awards this year to men who were outstanding, and Rusty is by all means in everybody's example and everybody's witness an outstanding man for his work.
Mankind Project Southeast Area honors Rusty Mills for his meritorious contribution and commitment and mission of service to the Southeast Area of Mankind Project on this day, December 2, 2018. The Mankind Project USA creates a world where men act on their individual and shared responsibilities for the future of humanity by initiating and supporting men on the path of emotional maturity, spiritual awareness, and deepening community.
So the third time that I met him, he called me one day and said, "Oh, guess what we're going to do?" And I said, "What?" I was over the multicultural portion of the Mankind Project for the Southeast. He said, "We're going to march in the Martin Luther King Day parade." It was about 0 degrees.
It was 24 degrees.
All the fountains were frozen. We all got there without any skull hats or anything, so the first thing we did was buy skull hats, and we walked the blocks and blocks. We had one pair of gloves that we shared among three people, and danced in the joy of being men who were there for every diversity. After that, I asked that we march in the Gay Pride Parade. Rusty was the one who jumped up and said, "That's terrific. Let's do it." And so we have walked in the Pride and the Martin Luther King Day parade since then, because this is a fraternity quite different than what fraternities are at the collegiate level. It's a fraternity of all diversities and love for every man for what he brings. So I asked Arnold to come down here with me to celebrate this person,
a man
who is a giant.
All right. Look over here, Arnold, brother. Yeah.
He is a
very
giant
big
in his gifts, a giant in his thoughts, a giant in his love and compassion. Every day that we walk the face of the world, we have the gift of having him walk with us. So, not only do we have this plaque that hangs on his wall, we have something as a reminder. And this is a reminder that this doesn't get on everyone's talisman. I'm about 25 beads behind, by the way. But this is probably the thing that every man should be the most proud of in the Mankind Project, period. We when you see a man that has this, and I'm going to pass it around, when you see a man that has this on their talisman, it means that they are of superior quality, superior gifts to the organization, and have done way beyond normal in bringing their gifts to you guys who are initiated, and to you guys who are not initiated. This man I can talk to about anything that I need to talk to you with pleasure. So, I'm going to ask you to put this on your talisman now.
So while he's doing that, let me just tell you a little bit more on the goals. Guys that are initiated know we always say we want to share our goal. We've got shadows, our bad side, but we all have goals. We want to share our goals. So the reason for the goal is he shares his goal all the time. We also say we are the gift. He is the gift. So part of the award ceremony was, let's do it in front of the group that he meets with, bring the gold. At the dinner, we presented the certificates. And incidentally, Paul got one also. Just not to slight anybody, we did five of them. But the gold bead is special, probably more special, and we wanted to present it in front of the men that he works with every day. Just to show a little more of that sharing. And when you look and you see gold, you know what we're talking about. Congratulations.
Just want to say that I have been the recipient of that gold. I've been giving a lot of that gold in the past year. When I was a broken man, and I didn't have a place to go, and Rusty opened his house, but I'm not saying just his house as the bridge right here, but his house. You know, when he opened his house, and he was able to welcome me, you know, with Zach, and then Leo came by, and then now Carl came by, the goal just keeps going and multiplying. You know, like Jesus the Christ that multiplied the bread, creation has given to Rusty the ability to multiply his gold. And that's a very beautiful thing. I wouldn't be standing here today. I wouldn't be pursuing school and being successful at work if Rusty had not opened his house and shared his gold with me. So I'm very thankful to MKP. I'm very thankful to the brothers that have been there for Rusty before me, right? And I'm just great. I'm so grateful to be part of this beautiful organization. You know, that is one of my pillars.
So I'd like to say a couple of more things. It's not just an organization that deals with the dark. It's an organization. It celebrates the light. So come up with us.
Yeah. Thank you.
There you go.
I just want to say, you know, this year we were 30 M plus at Pride.